Justin's top eight is 3 out of 5.
Yes. So Jabaley has just confirmed all of Injustice's top eight will be 3 out of 5. Unfortunately, you had to do 2 out of 3 for pools. Well, not unfortunately for me, because I got to scrub people out. 17th. But unfortunately for the competitors who expected 3 out of 5, we had to do 2 out of 3. But the good news is the tournament ran ahead of schedule. We were done
quite ahead of schedule. We were done with almost every pool at least like 30 minutes early.
One pool was 1 hour ahead of schedule. So Jabaley said, you know what, I just didn't want to take a risk, but next year, 3 out of 5, guaranteed.
Right.
No button check? All right, we're getting right into it. Chris G versus Forever King. Forever King going with Batman here. Chris G sticking with his trusty green arrow.
All right, Chris is in there right now. Getting a first combo, putting him in the corner. Oh, got him with the first overhead arrow.
There's another one. Reloads his arrow.
Nice neutral jump by King in the corner to get out. Oh, oh my God, setting up the room, but only gets an up bat for it. Good blocks.
Ooh, nice back dash.
Chris caught trying to interrupt that string right there, and King blocks the overhead arrow this time.
Back to, oh, Roomba
setting
set
up the Roomba. Chris nice. With a smart getaway.
Chris is so good at
avoiding
those.
All right, here we go. Forever King block string. Nice interrupt by Chris.
Parry. Wonder what he was looking for there. Meter burn back 3. Back 2-3.
And Chris gets hit by the overhead of that string.
All right, King's dashing in. Gets him with the cross up. 4-2. Drops the combo. Interesting.
Oh, no backhand. I think that's what he wanted there. I love how Chris is using those down arrows to just get over that Roomba and keep away from all those setups, because they are extremely dangerous on this stage.
You can get up to 80%. 80% or more with Batman with 3 meters. I'm sure someone found some more, but we'll say 80 to be safe.
All right, Chris is looking good. He just keeps getting like slightly hit every now and then. An arrow just can't keep up with Batman damage-wise right now.
Nice use of fire arrows there to keep him out.
All right, so we're about dead even going into the second life bar.
Stare down. Meter burn back 3. He staggers because it's a plus. Got to deal with this. Batman has a lot of safe strings. He has holes in them that a lot of people don't exploit, but if he hits you with them, they're relatively safe.
Oh, caught him with the mix-up with back 1-1. Going into the background bounce. What's
time
the
to guess.
Setup?
Whiffs a normal. Oh, goes
nice
for the jump
on the cross-up.
Uh-oh, and Chris just restarted the match. He didn't want to deal with it. So it's 1-0 Forever King.
Here we go, match two. Oh, sprinkles the money on him for first hit.
4-2 down 1-3, reload. Freezes him. He's going to use the interactable. Nope, reloads another arrow.
Nice block by King.
You want that?
Oh! Ooh.
Nice
huge
transition.
Convert.
I figured.
What's the score?
1-0 Forever King. So I figure since he's not getting his Roomba set up, he's going to go ahead and transition, try to use the other tools in the map, the stage. Now 1-1-3 has a gap in it. You can down one.
Oh, nice reactions by Chris to block that meter burn 4-3. He's got to find a way to load an arrow. There he goes. Oh, but King again gets him with an up batarang into a convert.
Time to guess. Whiffs a normal, goes for the cross up.
Chris is trying to interrupt that string. He's just not quite on point with it.
Knocks him out of there.
And this is one of those matchups where playing extremely lame or rushdown with Batman, it works either way. And King is just so good at both.
Here it comes.
Freezes him. Here we go. He's going to do the combo here. He's going to probably reload his arrow. There we go. He rolls an ice arrow.
Got him with the meter burn back 3. If I was Chris, I would probably flash here. Chooses not to.
He wants to sit on that super for now. If he gets touched again, he has no choice because he will die.
Oh, good punish on the Hurricane Bow, and he does have to clash.
He's got
to
bet it all, too. Minimum of 3. Decides to bet it all. Good choice. Fire arrows. Releases the bat, doesn't get a conversion.
Oh, got him with the meter burn back 3 again. No setup, just going all damage this time.
37%. Stagger back 3. He backdashes the next hit.
All right, Chris finally gets that life bar. Maybe it's just time for some moral victories to go into the third game.
Yeah, see what you can do here. We are in real master territory. Jump three.
Check this out.
Ooh, oh, wow. Nice fake out.
All right, Chris is actually not quite. Oh, and then
sprinkles.
Commentator's curse. All right, so King goes up 2-0, and Chris is giving it a really long think right now. Now, last week, the same exact thing happened to Chris against Darth Arma, and he brought it back 3-2.
That did happen
so
at MLG.
We will see if he can make the adjustment right here. Great trade to the Batarang. That's a great trade for Green Arrow.
Oh,
he misses it,
combo.
So he doesn't get his load.
That was crucial. He's got his Ice Arrow anyway. Reloads again. That was unsafe. All right.
Oh, didn't cancel it into the arrow, though. Oh, got him again with the little, like,
that's such a nice
mix-up.
Fake out, dude. Ruiz is the bat.
All right, King's activates setting up the Roomba. Oh, tried to scout him out of the air.
Chris G is really good at avoiding those setups. He knows. If you get hit with a meter burn back three with the Roomba, it doubles the damage.
All right, Chris caught him again. Going toward the corner now.
The combo
possible Roomba setup? No.
Unscaled.
Oh, and King was able to block, still got hit somehow. Chris again has not gotten hit by a single Roomba setup.
Reset. Chris has blocked every reset again. Uh-oh, does the back three too early there.
Oh, tried to wake up with useless arrow.
Ooh, nice. Dashes into the explosion.
Oh, and there is again, waking up with useless arrow.
Waking up arrow. He found a use for the useless arrow.
Oh, and a huge jump three convert by Chris here. Gonna be big damage going into the corner. Got him with the overhead.
He's so good with those overhead ice arrows.
And Chris is now a super away from winning. And it could be it right here.
That's it. Don't
King
drop
tried
back
the backdash,
oh,
but
he doesn't even bother.
He knows.
I wanted to see the super.
Now, yesterday in top or in their pool, Panic Mode actually backdashed the super.
He did. 7L does it all the time. When he, in Green Arrow mirrors.
Nice blocks by King there on the arrow. Oh, caught him moving though with the back two.
Back three. Down one's out. Got his ice arrow again. Watch out.
He just goes naked ice arrow, trying to find a way. Just King wasn't blocking low.
Yeah. He didn't fake him out this time. He tries the instant overhead.
Oh, that back three was so close. Oh, Chris doesn't fall for it. How do you make that read when Batman hasn't parried all set yet?
Here it comes.
He did from like half screen.
All right, so after going down two, Chris G is in the lead right now and getting a corner combo.
All right.
Some cheese.
Ooh. I don't know what that up batarang was for. He was way too close.
All right, Chris will probably. No, Chris actually did bet. And decides to take the damage instead of going for a late super reset.
Very wise choice.
All right, he's just going to keep loading up those fire arrows, trying to hit him like 8% at a time.
Oh, nice air-to-air. Chris is doing an excellent job of blocking here.
Check this out.
Meter burn battering. Tries to bait a jump.
Ooh,
oh, whiffs
wow.
A back three.
Back three.
Chris has his fire arrows out. He's ready to do
just
this
looking
damage.
For any kind of damage. Oh, meter burns.
You guys
he's
do
gonna
1%
kill him with normal arrows?
1%? Why not? Oh
he's
no.
Trying.
He got greedy.
This could be dangerous though.
He got too greedy.
You do not want to give Batman any chance. Oh, and here we go.
How about an arrow?
Chris
your
with
ass.
An early clash.
He doesn't want to deal with it. And why not? All he has to do is hit Batman once. Just keep shooting at him. Uh-oh. He's caught a bat.
And there we go.
Wake up, Savage Blast.
Wake up, Savage Blast. All right, so we are 2-2.
2-2.
Going to game number 5.
Will Chris G bring it back on both the Premier Batman players? In consecutive weeks.
And King chooses to switch stage, thinking that I guess he just thought the Hall of Justice wasn't doing
much for him. He couldn't get any Roomba set up, so why? I agree with that. All right, so we're in Metropolis right now. The gadget characters can use that car above the stage to blow it up and cover a small radius. Get some damage. And some nice resets. All right, King's got his bats.
Oh,
nice back three.
Oh, wow.
Does not get the conversion.
The third bat came out of nowhere after the back three hit.
1-1-3. Doesn't interrupt it with down one.
Ready, aim. Oh, and got him with the overhead. Oh, Chris misses the last end of that string, though, and that means he doesn't get an arrow load.
He's got a bat out.
Oh, got him with the overhead again.
And when Batman gets hit, he loses his bat. So he has to wait for a
chase. Oh, caught the backdash. Chris has been on fire these last three games.
Nice.
Oh, caught trying to interrupt. All right, what's the setup from King?
Trait reset. Chris has blocked all of these.
Chris again tries to interrupt and gets caught.
Gets hit with the end of it.
Nice push block just to get Batman off of him. Oh my god, and somehow the ice arrow still catches.
Oh,
slide misses.
Tries to end it with slide.
King push blocks. All right, how good is the magic pixel? It's extremely good here.
He's dead. Man, that magic pixel always comes back to haunt people.
All right, Chris needs to get rid of this pixel immediately. Great block on the cross up. Oh, but King got him.
Back 1-1-2, hard knockdown. He's hovering around that car.
Nice jump three. All right, so here we go. Final round. Chris does have super.
There's the bomb. Chris
dodges. Nice dodge.
It.
Oh, no punish. Nice block by King. Chris finally gets a slight interrupt on that string. Oh, caught the backdash again. And King clashes. Now, will Chris take the damage? One of them fake bet.
Let's find out.
And
no.
Chris, oh, both of them didn't bet anything.
Chris keeps his super. He wants that guaranteed damage. And
so
King doesn't have clash.
Chris is two hits away from winning this.
Yes, he is. One combo and then one freeze in the super. That'll do it.
Oh, but the back three from King, and Chris is forced to clash.
How many?
I think Chris will still keep his meter.
He bet it all.
Oh, he bet it all.
Interesting choice there.
All right, so now he just has to hit Forever King and
four times.
I guess it's just a fair fight now.
Yeah, he has to hit him a couple times. Batman has hit him twice.
Oh, meter burn batarangs into the gun. Almost a sick convert from Forever King. Again!
Oh my goodness, that's gonna do it. Wait, yep, 10 seconds left. Green arrow cannot kill you in 10
King
seconds.
With some late game antics, and he takes the set and moves on to winner's finals.
Christie's crucial mistake was betting all his meter.
Yeah.
He should have saved it for super.
He needed that damage, especially with so little time on the clock.
That would have been about 44%.
That's part of Green Arrow. You live and die by that clash or that super, and that's just part of his game.
I guess he panicked there. Who? Dragon Ball Z Budokai. Dang.
I respect this.
So we've got Dag 222 coming out to the Budokai 3 Anthem. That game was awesome. I just don't understand why. RG Sonic Fox.
Oh my god, he's riding the Mad Catz Tiger.
Is that the Skullgirls theme?
Probably.
Sonic Fox finding the closest thing to a fox in the venue, and it just happens to be Fire Liger. Shout out to Fire Liger, the FGC mascot.
Oh, God.
Yeah. Someone said boo. There's got to be that one guy. Plugs in his pad and it glows like his shirt. Same color. So Chris, Forever King moves on.
All right, and Deg is in the exact same place he was last year at this tournament.
Chris G.
When he was Scorpion Legend. And so, all right, they're going to button check with the previous characters.
Here you go, sir.
So I'm actually not sure who Deg will pick here. He has a multitude of characters, but I'm not sure which one will combat back row the best. Get down. And we all know Sonic Fox is just a whole different monster by himself.
I think Deg's got a surprise for the people today.
That's what I've been hearing as well.
I'm not going to spoil it like Michael Cole. All
right, both players kind of dancing around the select screen. Deg hovering over Batman.
Did you request a blind pick?
Spooky, can we get the split screen?
Uh-oh. He is highlighting Zatanna.
It looks like they're requesting a blind pick over there. I can't see.
Yeah. Sonic Fox picks his trusty Batgirl. Deg opts to hide his cursor.
Hide cursor and moved one space.
Who
in
could it
any
possibly
direction?
Be?
I have a thought, but we'll wait. We'll wait. All right, so we get the Watchtower, a stage that doesn't particularly favor Batgirl or mystery character.
By God, it's Batgirl!
Uh-oh.
Someone just panicked and paused. Deg opted to mirror Sonic Fox. No one has ever done this, and if they have, they haven't succeeded.
And Deg is one of those people that secretly plays a lot of characters. He told me yesterday that he's played Batgirl from day one.
Yep.
So
just never used her in the public eye. How you doing, Fire Liger? Are you Oh, man, you're funny. He's rubbing his nose on me. I'll give you a hug. There you go.
All right, so I'm not sure exactly what we're waiting on.
The Zatanna dream is dead. I think, what is Sonic Fox doing? All right, they're restarting
the
match handshake.
Restart match.
I guess it freaked him out so much he just mashed the pause button. How dare you mirror me?
All right. So it looks like we are right in there. All right. So Sonic Fox is the Batgirl with blue on.
Yes, that's
true. While Deg is the one in the full black original costume.
That's his trademark costume.
Nice punish of the teleport. Whiffs the normal. Oh, got him with the cross-up.
Uh-oh, Deg is winning here.
And you can definitely already tell that there's a difference of styles between the two players with their Batgirl.
And yesterday, Sonic Fox Girl Mirror, when Panic Mode was playing casuals, I said, you want to play with Panic Mode? He said, hell no, I hate that.
But Sonic Fox gets in and hits him with the low. What's the mix-up? Got him with the overhead again, and now we're in the corner. Big damage incoming.
He's dead.
Oh, yep. My God.
Two touches from Batgirl and you lose your life bar.
All right, Deg sitting in the corner. Got his cartwheel stuffed, and here we go.
He better clash.
Chooses not to.
Well, this
beats 44%.
Random teleport there.
Nice punish of the cartwheel, though.
Deg is still in this, ladies and gentlemen. He just needs those two touches.
Oh, somehow Deg gets hit by the interactable. Got him with the overhead.
Super. Oh, my God. He supered his jump in.
Oh, my God.
All right,
Sonic
Deg.
Fox.
Quit playing around and pick Zatanna. Ain't nobody got time for this. Go to the character select screen. Yes. Pick your girl. Stick with what you know.
All right. So Sonic Fox said he wasn't having any of that, but he chooses Batgirl again.
Did he really?
Same exact stage. It's almost like we hit the rematch button.
Why bother? 1-0 Sonic Fox.
So Deg actually started that set really well, but he just got hit in the corner twice. Chose not to clash on the beginning of the second life bar, and that was it.
Batgirl matches are the easiest to commentate.
And Sonic Fox with a big jump and no convert afterwards, though.
Oh, he got hit. Oh, he died. LOL.
Sonic Fox is making hay right now. What's the reset? Oh, it's an overhead.
That's wrong. What is Deg doing?
Just the
right
simplest
now?
Of overheads, and there it is again. And that's a perfect.
Yep, sure was.
Got him with the cartwheel, though. Sonic Fox jumps in, gets the overhead. He just cannot seem to guess wrong. That's huge plus frames. Let's finish
this. Oh, God.
Deg opts to clash early mid-screen. Probably a good choice. Because, like we said, if you get hit twice by Batgirl, you're dead.
All right, he's got to be careful approaching Sonic Fox in this corner. But Sonic Fox just says, nah, I'm running out. Got him with the teleport, too. What an insane read. Whiffs the normal. Overhead. Deg finally able to block one of the vortex attempts.
Drops the combo. I don't know what...
Oh, my God. And a nice anti-air. Using it just like a Shoryuken.
Yeah, it's going to hurt.
This could be game.
Nope.
Oh, extremely close.
He's got a pixel.
He's buffering teleport. You can see it. And
uppercut.
DP.
Buffered uppercut. Deg, just pick Zatanna. Please.
Right. So far, we've had two matches in the winner's top eight. Two people have gone up 2-0.
He's down 2-0.
We'll see if Deg can make an adjustment or if he'll pick a different character.
He needs to pick Zatanna. I don't know why he's playing around.
And I believe this is also Florida's last player still in the tournament, if I'm correct.
Gross.
Oh, you are right.
He went to Harley. Okay. We'll see.
It looks like no Zatanna. Yeah, there's no way he can possibly pick Zatanna for this set. Has to win three straight games with Harley Quinn.
And as we know, Saltface is 0-3 against Batgirl players with his Harley. So we'll see how Deg does. Begin.
Oh, got him with an instant jump, too.
Cartwheel. And we're at the Hall of Justice, where Batgirl pretty much controls the map. You jump, she can teleport. If she weren't in the middle of her bow animation, she could teleport and get the gunshots. Like Panic Mode was doing the Salt Face yesterday. Like that. And here we go.
Oh, Sonic Fox caught him low.
Yeah, this is bad. Oh, yeah.
Oh, got him low again, and that should be the round.
And if Sonic Fox wins this, this would be the second Florida Harley he's taken out. He took out Katana Prime earlier yesterday. Uppercut. Just clashes immediately, as he should. Let's
finish this. All right, Deg is going to have to do a lot of work. He's still got most of Sonic Fox's silver bar to go through.
Yeah, I don't think Harley was
trying to get some gunshots going, but trades with Ebola, and that is bad. Oh, got a vortex off of it, but no convert.
Oh, this is going to hurt.
And that is probably the worst thing that can happen when a Roomba setup goes on.
Reset. Gets hit with the bomb. And this is over.
Got in with another one. All right. Going to the corner. No. Sonic Fox dashes under, and that's damage.
3-0. He should have just picked Zatanna.
Sonic Fox with an emphatic victory, advancing to winner's finals, where he will face Forever King. Starting off the morning very good.
Well, you live and you learn.
And Deg will now have to trek through the loser's bracket.
All right, guys. So we are now going to the loser's bracket. First off, this guy's online popples. Are you getting this? It's Pig of the Hut.
Pig of the Hut online pop-offs. The announcers are funny. Oh, they cut his music short. Nope.
Uh-oh.
He's... Yeah! All right. He wasn't getting in without his music. Katana Prime, the hype man. Let's see here. Deg moves on. Sonic Fox moves on. Deg moves to losers.
And his opponent coming to the ring, I.E.
You gotta hold it straight up and down, man.
There
you go.
Newfangled contraption. Sonic Fox, Forever King. Ooh, that's interesting. Deg is loser. Pig.
All right, and this is probably going to be the crowd favorite right here.
Shazam!
Digit entering the ring. Taking it in for a moment. This is his first major top eight.
He did win Texas Showdown 2 months ago. Nice regional they had down there. Special guest Perfect Legend.
All right.
So we've got Digit from Texas versus Pig of the Hut from Atlanta. I'll let you introduce your buddy.
Yeah, Pig, what do I say about Pig? At the beginning of the game, he was huge in MK9, as we all know. Easily a top 10, possibly top 5 player. And in Injustice, he hasn't had quite the same success. But he's been on a roll these past 2 weeks, getting top 8 at MLG, and now top 8 at CEO, back-to-back top 8s. And the last time he did that, he rattled off 14 or 15 straight. So this might be picking up momentum for Pig of the Hut.
Yes, sir. The most successful Zod in the community.
And we'll see how he deals with the craziness of Captain Marvel.
He was practicing earlier. He got here at 9 o'clock.
Yeah, Pig takes everything extremely serious, and I'm sure he woke up at 8 a.m., here as soon as possible to make sure everything goes smoothly.
He was practicing command grab, escaping command grab setups with Salt Face earlier. And the 4-2-2 shenanigans.
And Pig has said that he's been feeling good this morning, so we'll see if that can carry over into the game. Just practicing on the setup.
All warmed up, and Digit's coming in cold, just having a seat right now, so we'll see how it goes.
Pig just trying to feel out timing.
Combo check, checking the monitor lag and all that good stuff.
All right, so here we go. Pig starting the match with a jump back. Digit teleporting in.
Starts off with a gun.
And Pig is already really close to the corner.
Gets caught calling trait with the tackle there.
Pig caught the teleport.
Again, he gets caught with a torpedo.
Oh my god, and the Pig was expecting a corpse hop there, but Digit stayed same side.
Yep.
Alright, first trait call. What's the mix-up? And got him low. Will he go for the Ten Commandments? No.
Zod falls. He catches the teleport.
Oh, and there's another big torpedo from Shazam. Nice wake-up by Pig, though. And again, takes the round with the pistol.
Very nice by Pig.
Pig calls in trait.
Immediately.
Oh, got him low.
Yep.
This is going to be big damage. Digit might need to clash early, but he chooses not to, and that's about 45%.
All right.
All right, Digit looks like he's trying to find a way in, but Pig scouts the dash.
Oh, down one into torpedo. Meter burn
4-3
to scout for wake
three.
Up. Pig of the Hut likes to wake up, and he got blown up for it against White Boy yesterday.
And if there's one thing about Digit, it's that momentum is his insane factor, and he's taking it right now.
Yes.
All right, Pig looks to clash to try to take and just force Digit off of him.
Trace slapping away. Digit doing a good job of blocking the mix-ups. Gunshot, no meter burn. There's
meter burn. Pig is going to go for the wall.
Yep,
oh.
He didn't have any meter to make it safe.
Oh, and I knew Pig.
Digit going for that back two from half screen.
Pig's got to be careful jumping back now. Oh, but there's a trait. Oh, but somehow the torpedo hits.
Nice meter
goes
burn
for the bite.
Oh, my goodness. This could be it. This could be it.
One mix-up. Oh. Pig blocks. Oh, 4-2, and you cannot clash the laser.
Man.
Just a clutch moment by Pig of the Hut there.
You hate to see that type of thing happen.
And that was one of the things he was practicing most, the post-torpedo guessing game, and he realized that Shazam really doesn't have much option after if he does 4-2.
Throws. The lightning bolt there. One of the worst projectiles in the game.
Good. Pig punishing that back 2-3. That is a punishable launcher from Shazam.
Calls his trait. Shoots him. Happy slappy. Wake up teleport.
Free interactable. Digit smartly meter burn back 3s just to not take so much damage.
He took half the damage there.
Oh my god. Stuff the Zod charge on wake up.
Meter burn cancel works like
and this
FADC
is going to be death.
Street Fighter.
Shazam. And just like that, Digit now has the advantage.
Except you don't get your health back.
Here we go. Zod trait. Nice block. Nice block again. Oh, but somehow gets hit.
Got opened up. Doesn't get a full combo, but it doesn't matter. You know, he had a pixel.
All right, dead even.
Pig's about to get his trait back.
Ooh, Pig with a big whiff. Pig just backdashing out of the way like it's for fun.
Doesn't want to get hit by those back two.
Oh, but got hit with the command grab. The wake up trades and caught him with a 4-2. I think that's a smart clash by Digit. He was about to get background bounce for huge damage and possibly a trade call.
That elbow that Shazam's throwing out starts a lot of his combos. So he's got a
good push block by Digit. Ooh.
Fish for it.
Pig getting hit by the torpedo.
Pig with a Zod charge.
Aaron's Zod charge there by Pig.
Might be getting a little too greedy with those. Ducks the lightning bolt.
All right, Pig has to wait a long time for his trade to come back.
Yep.
He's going to keep backdashing until he gets to the corner. Zod charges out. All right, trade is back. Will he call? Yes, he does. Nice. That grab, I believe, punished. I heard the bone crunching sound. All right, Pig just
one
hit away.
Here. Uh-oh.
He's got to be careful. Oh, nice wake-up Zod charge, and Pig goes up 2-0.
Digit was trying to do something meaty there when he got hit with the wake-up Zod charge. So that's 2-0 Pig on his way. Let's see where he goes here. On his way to fight Chris G if he wins this.
But we've nice. Seen jump back two in the Zod charge. I believe he wanted 4-2, but nice punish of the teleport. Pig has been on point scouting those. Oh,
misses
trade
the trade grab.
Oh, no, he cannot do that against Shazam. Oh, set up.
Trades up.
Oh, but nice meter burn back three from Pig to counter.
Unfortunately,
playing
Shazam's
insanely
trade does
well
not
right
work
now.
Like Superman's, and he can't break the armor.
Down one torpedo by Shazam. Corpse hop setup. Oh no, and he doesn't chip him with the Zod charge and gets hit with an elbow. Alright, Pig is one hit away. Probably a Zod charge. Keep going for it? No, down one. Pig calls in trait. Knows not to go for the overhead bite this time. Forcing him full screen, possibly going to go for the globe.
Trying to zone him out. That's how
three
he fights.
3 meter
Shazam.
Burn lasers in a row.
You just got to keep him out. You don't want to deal with the mix-ups.
Oh, wow. Naked background bounce.
They just got 2 meters here. Hits him with a torpedo.
Corpse hop set up. And Pig clashes.
That's exactly what Pig does not want to deal with. So that's why he's trying to zone him out, keep him full screen, and he clashes quickly.
And Pig does have trait, calls it in immediately.
Nice. Trying to get him with the grab. Nope.
Nope, just going for chip at this point. Good blocks by Digit.
Nice
trades
jump
with
one,
the jump
trade.
Two. Oh, and Digit was going for a whiff punish there, but Pig just said, I'll do the whole string. Oh, got him with a torpedo. What's the setup? Trades with the wake up. Pig again stuffing the dash, and that could be it. Calls in the trait. And just Zod charges over. That'll be it. 3-0 to Pig of the Hut.
So he's going on to fight Chris G. I don't think that match has ever happened.
I am not sure if that has ever happened.
I think last night Pig was hoping he won his match that he lost so he would fight Chris G in winners. He wanted it. Because I don't think there's much Arrow can do about Zod.
Yeah, from what I hear, that is an atrocious matchup. So we'll see what Chris has up his sleeve for that one.
Can we say at least 7-3?
Yeah, I would probably go into that territory.
But Chris did take out Rasan. Wait a minute. We've got an interruption by The Miz. Oh, he's got the douche shades on. Definitely in character. Salt Face, a.k.a. The Miz. When he picked up Doomsday, he decided that was his heel turn. So he will be playing
to the ring, D.R. Gross.
D.R. Gross. Is that Tupac?
Katana Fraud just fell.
Oh, he's got Biggie. Katana Prime with the Ric Flair sell. I agree with that. I love that. Oh, he's got his trademark pop-off. See, when Gross defeats Perfect Legend, he always licks his hand. That's his gimmick. And people have been using that every time they beat Perfect Legend.
And he also used the intro song Big Papa, because after he beats you, you become his son.
Yes. Thank you for enlightening us on that, Smart. I forgot. He says, CD Jr. is my son. Who else is his son?
Perfect Legend. Gross has a lot of sons at this point.
Yep.
Quite the father.
I don't think he's paying child support, though.
All right. So, Saltface, 1 year removed from making his first top eight at this tournament, has seen himself again in the ring. And now, last year, he lost immediately in the top eight. I forget to who, but he's going to look to just not repeat that same thing. And now, this is interesting because Gross has a lot of experience against both of Saltface's characters, Harley and Doomsday, and it looks like he's going to go Harley.
Green Lantern. Yep. And the thing is, Gross has experience fighting both of these characters. He plays Katana Prime and Newbie a lot.
Yeah.
Every major, they run like hour-long sets. So he's familiar with both. We'll see if he can adjust to Saltface's style, though. Because that plays a huge factor in deciding the victor here. Because Saltface defeated Newbie yesterday, so let's see if he can take out Gross, too. All right, we're getting right into it here.
Jump in straight.
Guys, if you support Saltface, type PJ Harley in the chat room. That is capital PJH and then A-R-L-E-Y. She's got a nice little cute
all
icon.
All right, so both characters going to their zoning game early.
Saltface is
all right, but Gross is having enough of that. He wants to get in and do some setups. Somehow the jump three misses.
I don't think Harley can do anything about back 1-3 rockets. Nice meter burn missile.
Gross meter burns. This could be a life bar. Oh, but he drops,
drops it.
Wake up tantrum stance. And what's the setup by Saltface? Got him with the overhead.
Yep.
Meter burns the back three for damage.
Saltface is not here.
Uses the bar meter in the corner as well.
He used all of his meter on push blocks, meter burn back threes, and play doctors. He is not stingy with it.
Nice jump two. Jumps into the corner. Not sure how I feel about that. No punish by Gross on the cartwheel. But gets him with a meter burn missile. Oh, scouted the cupcake and got in. Saltface forced a clash early. And might take some damage right here.
Very close match right now. We're even on meter, almost even on life. Green Lantern has his clash available.
Oh, Saltface gets hit.
It's going to be 50%. Oh, he just does the reset. Okay.
Cross up 4-3. This is huge damage.
He's dead.
This is over.
He's dead. Yep.
And just like that, two setups by Gross, and that was life.
And that jump three combo he had in the corner could have been 50.
Yeah.
I've seen it. I've felt it.
All right, trades with the tantrum stance there. Saltface looking to get some pressure going.
Nope.
I believe you're right. I'm not sure Harley can do anything about those missiles. Saltface just choosing to block. Oh, meter burn back three on wake up.
Man, those jump three combos. He went for a reset there. It's a neutral jump three.
All right, trades with the cupcakes.
I think Gross has the dirtiest Green Lantern in the game.
Yeah, some of his setups are insanely hard to see and block.
Right. It looks like a combo, and you're sitting there like, when did the reset,
yeah,
the counter reset?
Many times he OTGs you, and you don't even know.
You don't even see, I was looking right at the screen,
yeah,
and didn't see it. It's amazing.
It does literally just look like part of the combo. All right, Gross going back to zoning. Gets under the cupcakes. All right, he's going to go for damage here. Oh, nice.
Ooh.
Silly slide out by Saltface.
All right, what's he going to do here?
Neutral jump setup.
Nice
down
one.
Oh, caught him trying to hit buttons. Saltface is a monster in the corner.
He is. He has some dirty
stuff. Oh, but got him with the lift. Gross say no jump.
Nope. She clashes quickly, but she's at a meter deficit. Is Gross going to take the life?
And I think Saltface is clashing just to keep away from those setups, which are so dangerous.
Yes, he is. Since Gross had more meter, he did damage, and he only bet one. Saltface didn't bet anything.
And Saltface gets hit by another air-to-air.
This could be bad.
And that was a tricky setup by Gross there. Down 1-4-3. Oh, ooh. Got him with the lift, though.
Nice lift.
And Gross is going to go up 2-0.
Katana Prime clapping in the background. His training buddy. Gross's training buddy.
All right, and what does Saltface do here? He's thinking.
Is he going to pick Doomsday? Gross is laughing like, Harley, I play newbie.
Harley has not worked so far.
I play newbie. Doomsday. Don't pick Doomsday.
And I heard Doomsday.
Yep, he did it. He's laughing. He's like, he knows. Gross is very comfortable in this matchup.
Yeah, I mean, I'm not sure what Saltface is supposed to do here. I mean, Gross trains against the only other two Harleys and all the Doomsdays.
Yep. Gross is excited. He's like, I win.
Yeah.
All right. Jump back missile.
All right. And this is probably what most of the game is going to be like. Nice trip guard with the back one. Set up.
Yep.
Cross up.
There it is. That jump three reset.
Oh, and he went for something ambiguous. Saltface saying, I'll just wake up this time.
I think he did it too early. Ooh, nice,
nice back
dash. Approved.
Oh, but Gatling gun.
That blows up Doomsday's trait, and it's going to expire now.
Good blocks on Earthshaker. Oh, but the down two gets stuffed.
Tried to buy Splash. Another block on Earthshaker.
Somehow back two reach from that range.
Nice missile. Ooh, tries to press buttons between the rocket. Gross is doing a good job of keeping Saltface out right now.
And Gross is just blocking everything.
Like we said, he has extensive Doomsday experience with the Florida Doomsday, so this is good to hope with
Saltface. Saltface just going for an interactable. Oh my god, this zoning looks broke.
Nice.
Oh, well, got him with the lift out of nowhere.
Yep. There's the clash. Gross doesn't have the meter to keep him from getting his health back, but it doesn't matter at this point. Gross knows all of Doomsday's tricks here. Throws him in the corner. Meter burn 4-3. He knows how to get out of that.
Oh, 4-3 stuffs the wake
up. 4-3, yep. Takes it convincingly. 3-0 Gross. Thanks to his training buddies, Katana Prime and Newbie. And Saltface is out of the tournament, repeating his performance from last year. Got 7th place.
All right, next up, I need Chris G versus
nothing
Gross.
To sneeze at there. Chris G versus Gross. This is going to be very interesting. I don't think Chris G has seen these setups from Lanterns on the East Coast. I don't think, because no one does them. No one does them except Gross. DJT just found out about him at MLG in the middle of the tournament. He hit the lab for 15 minutes and got it down. 50%. He's like, I'm halfway secure with these. Like, man, if DJT implements these setups in this game, it's going to be a problem.
Switch these two. This bracket's just, it's written wrong.
Okay. Loser of A1.
Yeah, it's like the bracket's just set up wrong. The, on their challenge bracket, Deg is up here and Chris is up here because Chris is about to play Gross right now.
Okay. You have 5 seconds to get here to check in. I was like, I knew I read that correctly.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Switching with Chris.
Yeah.
All right.
All right, funny story while we're in intermission. So yesterday at the pool party, Gross walks up to Chris G, and he's like, no one wants to money match you in Marvel, but come money match me in Injustice. And Chris just laughed at him.
Oh, that's sad.
So, and they had a little talk about it afterwards, and it looks like they're actually going to get to play now.
Chris G with a nice Gamester Gear jersey.
Representing his new sponsor.
I believe they're also sponsoring the tournament.
I would not be surprised if they are.
Yes, sir. Got confirmation from the stream runner. So we've got Chris G versus Gross. Chris G, Premier Green Arrow player. Oh, here's the promo. Gamester Gear. Use the promo code CEO4GG to get 30% off this gaming headset at GamesterGear.com. It's the Cruiser. All right. Quick cheap plug there. Now, Chris G is defending his title from last year. He went through the tournament in Winners during the Great Scorpion Scare. I'm sure you remember.
Oh, dude, the Great Scorpion Scare.
And he said,
part of the reason I did not come here last year.
Really? I did not know that.
He said, what's the big deal? You just got a book.
I play Black Adam, though.
I play Marvel. You know what I got to deal with? You guys are complaining about Scorpion? Like, what?
It was nothing for Chris. So there were four Scorpions in top eight. He just ran through them. I believe he beat a couple in pools, too, with Green Arrow.
People were like, oh, Scorpion 7-3 is the entire cast.
Scorpion was BS. He needed to be toned down, but not to the extent that he was.
Now that character
is... He was castrated.
Yeah. That character is almost unpickable on the screen. But we did see Perfect Legend pick him yesterday. And that was part of a set with Gross, where Gross had an amazing comeback in Game 3.
Uh-oh, what happened? Did Gross pick a stage? Green lantern. Green arrow. They're having a good time together.
Yeah, I'm sure Chris isn't a big deal, the stage, for Chris. I don't think he really cares. But, all right, here we go.
Starts off with back 1-3, minigun. Again.
And Chris did play, well, that was probably a year ago at EVO, the last time he has actually played a high-level Green Lantern in DJT.
I believe you're right. Ready, aim. All right. They're opting to zone each other out here. Chris G trying to freeze Gross, and Gross trying to hit him with a missile.
Oh, got him that time.
Combo, he's in the corner.
No wake up by Gross. Nice interrupt, though.
Gets in with the jump three.
Nice blocks by Chris. All right, and in the past, Chris has had some problems dealing with back 1-3 Rocket. That was one of the main things that DJT abused at EVO.
Ooh.
Nice interactable setup.
That was nice.
Trades with the ice arrow. Got him with the throw. Throwing him back toward the corner. Oh, right. Caught the back dash.
Nice savage blast there. Chris G has full meter right now. It's blown up by a meter burn missile, and Gross takes the first round. Close set here.
All right, Chris going to fire arrows near the end of this life bar.
Catches him. Chris G has really good aim.
Oh, Chris just making the reads on when Gross is going to jump, faking him out. And Chris might stick to fire arrows for the rest of the set. Just zoning Green Lantern out overhead.
Making great use of those fire arrows, because Green Lantern's mobility.
And by the time Gross gets in, Chris is going to just be in super reset territory.
Yep. If he hits him once with the freeze, he's got it loaded. He needs to hit him with that ice arrow to get this super, and that will be it. He tried to
Chris
do it.
Trying to find an interrupt.
Gross knows. Gross is going to keep throwing
knows.
Out back ones. He's like, no, I don't want to deal with that.
All right, what's the
reset
setup?
Oh,
oh
man.
Nice
that was
block
tricky.
By Chris.
Very tricky.
Oh, no. Full screen traded up gun does hit.
Freezes him.
Dash forward super. And this should be a kill. If
back
not,
three.
It's going to be very... Oh, I don't think it's just quite
Pixel.
Enough.
Pixel.
Oh, my God. And Chris G is just able to survive and trade with the meter burn missile and win.
Man, if that was a double KO... I don't know what I'm
oh,
gonna.
Man, that would have been insane.
I know, dude.
All right, what's the setup? Next cross up. Oh, but Gross doesn't convert and gets whiff punished. Chris, lucky for Gross, Chris did not have an arrow stocked. Caught the dash again. Chris messes up the back three. Stuffed him on wake up, trying to shove out a normal. Chris crossing over. Gross not blocking.
All right, Gross at the back one. Freeze.
Got him with the overhead.
Reload.
Chris is showing Gross that, you know, he has to learn to block two against him.
Yep.
Oh, got him.
Now, Chris is in full control right now, doing an excellent job of spacing Gross, keeping him zoned out.
Chris's use of fire arrow this game has been key just to keep Gross out.
Dashes
finally
forward.
Dashes
nice.
Forward and gets the punish.
He learned from last year.
Yeah.
People Chris told him at EVO he didn't get it.
What do I do about that?
Chris just, like, seemingly adapting during the set without anyone even talking to him.
That's amazing.
Just learning how to get out of setups on his own. And there it is again.
There's another four dash. He didn't get the punish, though. It was a little late.
Oh, good blocks. Oh, tried to jump out, though. Interactable setup by Gross. Gross is probably, yep, go for a throw or chip, and he got the throw. All right, Chris G's in the corner. Got to be careful. And tries to down one under a 4-3, and that does not work.
Combo.
How many 4-3s? Only one. I've seen Gross do four.
Yep.
One. Oh, goes low.
Dashes forward.
No punish.
I wouldn't do any back 1-3 rockets anymore. He knows the 4
Yeah,
dash.
Chris is now adapting to that setup.
Super. Uh-oh. Got him.
And this could be back 3 into back 3 for a transition. Never mind. Green arrow does jump over.
Okay, what's he going to do here?
Fire arrows.
Fire.
Nice duck by Gross,
oh,
though.
Oh, he missed. Oh, my God. What's going on?
Chris clashes. And one of them kept their bar. I'm sure it was Gross. Jeez.
Reloads. Fire arrow.
Oh,
one more shot.
Arrow.
One more shot. No,
oh,
he ducked it. Here we go again. This is just my last round.
Got him with regular arrows. Jumps the Savage Blast.
1%
oh,
arrow.
Oh, my God. 1%
arrow
for the kill.
For the win. Man. I want to see a double KO.
Christopher G,
I want to see a double KO. What happens in Injustice during a double KO is there's a slight pause for 3 seconds. Then both of them get their red bars back. It's a little bit of red health, right?
I believe it's 30%.
30%.
And I believe the match clock goes to like 15 seconds.
Yep.
I think I've only ever seen it happen once in tournament.
At final round.
Just crazy.
With Sickness and the Nightwing player. His name escapes me.
Emperor Merc. All right, set up. Oh, got him with the 4-3 this time.
Rose going for the damage here.
Back
into
the
corner. Reset.
Oh, it doesn't convert. Yep. I'm not sure if that crossed up.
That he should have just done that combo. That would have killed him. Lots of Lantern players go for unnecessary resets when they should just take the damage, especially in Gray Bar. There's no reason not to just take
the
damage.
Oh my god. Trades the missile from full screen.
That health is
Chris
come
G
back
showing tomorrow. That matchup knowledge right now.
Chris G should be dead right now, but Gross didn't finish the job and is coming back to haunt.
Oh, got him with the overhead. That's the first time Chris has used that.
He may lose his life bar right now.
Overhead doesn't block
there
the low either.
He got corner carried because he didn't finish that combo.
And Chris did about 75% on that little bar of health that he has left because Gross didn't finish that combo.
You have to take advantage of
him. Oh my god, good punish on the use of a tallow. Ooh, scouts the lift with a Savage Blast. Oh, Chris just great at counter poking. Chris has got to be careful here, and Gross is forced to use two bars of meter just to put Green Arrow on his second bar.
Down one
freeze. Oh, and that is another super.
44% coming up. Back three and back three. There you go.
All right, and just
fire
arrows again.
Trying to hit him with those.
Gross has to do something here, and there's a big jump back three by Chris. 3-0. Yeah. He swings his entire bow.
Insane. It was 3-0, but the score does not reflect the competitiveness of the match.
Games 1 and 2 were insanely close. So Chris G advances into the top 4.
On loser side. Pig of the Hut versus Deg. This will be interesting. I wonder how Zod Zatanna goes, or if he'll even use Zatanna.
I am not sure, actually. I believe he will lead with Zatanna.
He should.
But I could definitely see an Aquaman pick at some point.
Because Pig hates Aquaman.
Pig hates Aquaman.
Can't stand it. Slayer's secondary Aquaman was getting games off Pig, and he was furious about it. Were you there? No, you weren't at MLG.
No, I was not at MLG.
He was streaming it. Sawyer's like, oh, I just kind of picked up Aquaman for fun, and
beating
that's
Pig. That's not good.
Nope. This goes to how frustrating that is. All right, we've got Extension, premium arcade gaming equipment. Don't trade in that old Xbox 360 or PS3 just yet. Only $449. Sit-down arcade cabinet works with any arcade stock. Supports up to 32-inch flat-screen monitors. Xbox One and Xbox 360. Use the coupon code CO2014 for 10% discount at godlikesounds.com. And we've got Mad Cats Fight Stick Pro, only $79.99, normally $129.99. Save $50, free shipping. The coupon code is CEO2014 at store.madcats.com. Offers valid through July 1st, 2014.
All right.
Round shipping charge not included.
Looks like we're going to go ahead and get a button check going on here. And it looks like Deg is going to pick Satana. We'll be seeing her for the first time in top eight. Hi, Big D. How are you feeling this morning?
Dude, nice glasses.
Big D looking
America.
Hella American this morning.
You left some shit on Wingsmith.
What?
Just like food.
It was pig stuff. Yeah, that's fine.
All right, so Metro Rooftop. And Deg just zoning.
Oh, he's stepping off with Satana. All right.
All right, Deg with some good blocks early. Looking for that dash in, caught him with a down one.
Ooh, nice.
Oh, and there's a reset.
That was so dirty.
Wow.
Oh, he drops it. Oh, he drops it again. Let's see who's got here. Standing three into kicks. Does not meter burn. He doesn't have the meter for it. Jump three. Oh, no. She tried.
Gets wall dashing. Oh, but Pig just not able to convert that combo there.
Meter burn rings.
And Pig's going to have a hard time dealing with this ring zoning. Zod is not quite equipped for something like that. And then he gets caught with a dive kick.
I think Pig and Mr. Molina agreed that this matchup is 5-5. They ran some two-hour-long sets a little while ago. I watched those on YouTube.
All right, Pig opens him up. This will be the life bar. So it looks like Pig's game plan is just to, like, wait until he can get trait every time.
And he's getting zoned out with those rings. It's pretty
good. All right, going into hat stance, but she gets hit.
She can't move.
Wake up, meter burn ring. Trade is out, but he just wakes up with the overhead bite and forces Deg to clash early. Welcome to a world of pain.
Scorpion King. I just noticed the name.
Deg known for signing up with troll names.
It was
even
Scorpion
at
Legend, yeah. But let's let that rock for the sake of the rock. Don't change it.
All right, and Pig is just letting himself get zoned out right now. Meter runs the ball. She reflects.
Oh, he changed
it. All right, what's the setup here? No, Pig is just going for damage. Oh, teleports away.
Ooh,
oh,
right in his face.
Somehow got smoke and mirrors. I think that was an input error,
yeah,
and that
so.
Could cost him.
He could have died right there.
Pig's got to be careful. Meter burn rings are going to be flying.
Yep.
Ooh! Trade?
Rings!
Oh,
no,
he tried
to
teleport, but got caught.
You hate to see that type of thing happen.
And Pig goes up 1-0.
Second guess the rings there. All right, he's sticking with Satana.
Going for a change of stage and gets one that's just as bad.
I feel like if Deg loses this game, he's going to pick Aquaman.
I feel like that would come next, yes.
Yep.
All right, so we go from Metro Rooftop to the Watchtower. Deg looking for something right there with Stand 3. Got him with the dive kick for first hit.
Yep. Ooh.
Oh, got hit by the overhead. Teleports away.
Hit
trying
by the trade.
To stay away from that trade as much as possible. Nice dive kick again. Oh, meter burn ring. Oh, Pig able to dodge a trance star.
Did not meter burn the kicks.
And I can't remember if they are punishable when he doesn't meter burn or if
he does.
I was
just thinking about that. I don't think they are.
One is -3 and one is -8. I just can't remember which.
I'm pretty sure the meter burn is -3.
Yeah.
Otherwise, that would be counterproductive.
Yeah.
All right, he's zoning him out with rings here, doing a much better job than last round. Yep. And Satana can alter the trajectory of her rings. So if you jump, she can aim it upwards. If you squat, she can aim it downwards. Whoa,
ooh,
that was weird.
That was
kind of
glitchy. Yeah, when you meter burn through the trait, it's a little weird. Like, sometimes the visuals kind of glitch out.
It's like she went invisible there for a second. All right,
so Pig finishes out the round.
Pig has
Satana
no meter.
Is in the corner, and she's got... All right. Oh, teleports out. Nice jump one by Pig. Oh, but he punishes the trait call.
Now he does meter burn kicks. Full combo.
All right, what's the setup here?
Reset.
Oh, ooh. Pig somehow blocked it.
Oh, my goodness. Like, what?
Nice push block. Pig didn't want to deal with any more shenanigans right now.
Down one kicks.
No meter.
Didn't have any meter to meter burn it.
Punish that.
Oh,
nice.
That's punishable.
Interactable setup. Yes.
Yep. And he gets her with the full damage there.
Trait comes out. Oh, ooh, teleport.
No. Sweep. Oh, he has Clash.
Oh, where,
time to guess.
Where is she?
He guessed wrong. Wait, where'd you go?
Nice use of smoke and mirrors by Deg to even the score.
For
one
those
to
who
one.
Don't know, Zatanna can choose which one she is in smoke and mirrors. She can be the one on the middle, she can be one on the left, the one on the right. You just input a different
and that
command.
That allows for some really dangerous setups on Knockdown.
It's an illusion. She's a magician.
Oh, Deg again with that setup.
Ooh, that was cool.
That is so dirty.
Reset that reverses your inputs. So for like 2 seconds.
All right, both guys getting a couple of small input errors. Pig ducking on the overhead ring.
If she does regular trance, your inputs get reversed. If she does a meter burn trance, you're stuck there for like 5 seconds. She can do a full combo.
Oh, and these ring zoning is just so powerful.
All right, she's got 2.5 bars. Goes one on rings.
Nice saw charge to
gets caught
beat
in the
out
air.
The drone. Good blocks by Deg.
Very nice. Calls trait. Throws a meter burn ring. She doesn't have meter anymore. Gets opened
oh,
up by the low laser.
Low.
And that'll take her health bar.
All right, so this set has been extremely close all three games so far. Oh, Pig not having any of that dive kick. Trait comes out. Deg still trying to zone during.
Oh,
oh
no. Wake
nice
up kick.
Bait on the kicks on Wake Up.
She's going to get her health back here. Is she going to bet too? Yes.
25% recharge. Trades with the laser, and Pig loses a bar for that.
Hat stands.
Oh, my gosh. The zoning is so powerful.
She can't walk very fast. She can't block or she'll lose it.
All right, trade call. Watch out for teleport. Interactable.
Hat stance gives her immense projectiles and a 12% armored attack, but she can't move very fast, and if she blocks, she loses it.
All right, Pig was trying to get a zoning advantage there. Oh, and now Deg has it again. Oh, anti-airs. Oh, no, and Pig just... Saw charge right to him.
2-1 Deg. He's feeling it right now. Oh, nice air to air. Zod takes it with his jump one. All right, he calls his trait. She teleports away. Pig Zod charges
on him low. Oh, he went for a mix-up that he did not need to go for.
Correct.
Had the combo, and now he's paying for it.
And his inputs are reversed, and he got reset, but she didn't get the combo. And
watch out for the dive kick after.
Yep. So now we know it's safe.
He's going to go for it. Got the interactable. Oh, almost got a big jump in there.
Ooh, nice rings.
And trading with those rings is just huge damage for Zatanna.
Yep. Tries to Zod charge, gets smacked in the face.
Got him with the clap.
Deg takes the first round. One game away from moving on, knocking Pig out of the tournament.
The Pig looks like he's getting a little frustrated with his zoning.
Yep.
But takes the round with a meter burn push.
All right.
Calls in trait immediately.
We're all tied up. Zatanna has the meter advantage.
Oh, and caught him with that overhead. Pig getting a little risky, but paying
unclashable.
Off. Unclashable. Tried to bait a teleport there.
Yep. Very smart by Pig. Ooh, nice ring zoning by Deg. He's at a meter right now. He's building another one. Gets shot soon as he builds it. Pig doesn't want to deal with the meter burn
Pig
ring.
Throws the interactable. Got the trade with the
this is gonna
the
hurt.
Bite. Oh, no.
Drops
he drops
a back
combo.
Three.
Oh, and
oh
Deg
my god.
Jumps out.
No, he clashed
forced
immediately.
Clash.
Take it. Is he going to take it? Oh, my god. He's not going to take it. He's going to keep the meter for the damage for a combo. Because Pig can't get his
right,
health back.
Dead
he didn't have
even.
Any meter.
Pig has to get another
oh
trade before the end of this match.
Catches her out of the air. This is looking bad for Zatanna.
Oh, and Deg clashes.
Deg wanted his health back.
Probably
okay.
Will bet 2 bars here and still keep one. And he does. Throws the ring. And he's going to zone. And Pig's trait has to recharge fully again.
Oh.
Pig interrupts with down one.
Oh my
trait
goodness.
Is almost back.
Oh my goodness, Deg. Oh my god, we're in the same pixel.
Oh my god, and Deg just forcing the zoning down his throat. Woo!
Oh man. That was an intense match, dude. That could have gone either way. Dead even. 5-5 at its finest. Scorpion Legend moves on.
All right, so we are officially in top four here.
All right, so our top four winner side is Sonic Fox versus Forever King. Loser side is Deg versus Chris G.
So two of the top four from last year returning.
Magic as easy as 1, 2, 3. Has this match ever happened?
I've
never seen it.
I don't believe it has, actually.
This has never happened.
That is surprising.
These two have never run into each other in tournament in a year.
Actually, this may have happened at TFC last year.
Did it? I don't think so. Wasn't King in Winners? Because he had to fight KDZ in Winners Finals.
But Sonic Fox was also in Winners Top 8 at TFC. I think King may have beaten Sonic Fox at that tournament.
Wow, he lost to Cowboy. Sonic Fox beat Cowboy in Winners.
Right.
And then lost to him in Losers.
Losers.
So was it King?
It might have been,
but I
cannot remember, actually.
I think he lost to KDZ.
Are you sure?
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah, that actually does sound right.
He lost to KDZ because he
had
that.
This may not have ever happened, actually.
Yep.
That is crazy.
Never happened.
Normally, these two are favorites to be top three at most of the majors they go to. And they are both guaranteed to be top three here.
Doing a little button check here with the characters on the screen, then they're gonna switch to their mains. Looks like we've got a Dominican button check here. The CD Junior special. CD Junior, Rio, VSM guys. They like to do combo checks.
To the point where you can't actually tell if it's the real match.
Right.
They'll get down to like the last hit and then they're like, all right, we're
ready. All right,
ready.
Restart match. What?
I'm like, what?
Okay.
Shout outs to Reza for providing headsets for our main stage stream station also. All right. Oh, is King pulling out the glasses early? The reverse Wesker?
Now you know it's real. When King gets serious about a match, he puts his glasses on to make sure he sees every mix-up.
It looks like King is going to lead with Batman. I believe he actually agrees with Rena Rax that Batman can actually beat Batgirl 6-4. And part of it is because Meter Burn Batarang recovers instantly, so it baits out the teleport for a huge punish.
Right.
So we'll see if King can take advantage of that.
If anything, I would say slight 5.5 Batman. If there's
but
advantage.
It doesn't matter when you're in a vortex.
Nope, exactly. That's why I wouldn't give him 6-4.
Oh, and King misses the convert on the combo. Sonic Fox choosing the push block. I don't think I've ever seen Sonic Fox do that.
Punish teleport.
All right, here comes the setup.
Reset. Tries to jump three.
I don't know if it's just how good the players are in top eight, but King has not had much success with those resets. And it might just be a testament to how good the people are in top eight at blocking.
He's dead. Once again, guys, Batgirl touches you twice, you die. There's not much to say here.
And King smartly gets out of the corner with bombs, using one of those luxuries of being a gadget character. One of the few. Oh,
uh-oh.
Nice backdash by Sonic Fox.
Catches the whiff. Cartwheels him. He's going to put him to the corner.
Nice down one by King to interrupt.
Nice
oh,
jump two.
Nice jump two.
Dash
is through. Oh my god. Just a psychic teleport by Sonic Fox right there.
Reset.
Nice block.
Nice block. Because that would have been his health bar. And he would have been
forced to clash. And this will be Sonic Fox's health bar.
Yep. Sonic Fox has 3 bars. Well, just about 3 bars. And King has 1.5.
King with a nice dodge and the interactable blow up. And I love how this battering just kind of dissolved into the crown.
Uh-oh. Bates
and
the
there
teleport.
It is, just like I was talking about. If you meet up run the batarangs, you will instantly recover.
He's going to punish that every time. Sonic Fox has to stop. This is what got him killed at TFC.
Yes.
Now that we mention it.
Oh, and she ducks the back three. Oh, and here we go. Opens him up low, and King clashes. Going to lose probably at least 25% health here, possibly more. And he loses 30. Oh, nice punish on the glitter, and got him with the cartwheel to take game number one. All right.
Sticking with Batman here. Forever King has a pocket Martian that's really good.
And Sonic Fox has struggled against Martian in the past. We've seen him against
Jupiter
multiple times.
Jupiter 3-0'd him at MLG, and he got him at Civil War 2. So I think King's best option, if he loses this game, is to go with Martian there.
All right, so King gets the first combo. And again, Sonic Fox blocking. But gets caught this time trying to jump out of the corner. King goes for a setup, but it was just a bait.
Yep. Reese Bat back three.
And this could be a perfect, and it is.
All right, King's feeling good right now. But like we said, you get touched twice. There goes your life bar.
Oh, and I'm sure Sonic Fox wanted back one there, but got a batarang.
Reset. Activates trait, does jump three.
Sonic Fox push blocking immediately and going right to his trusty teleport.
And to the corner we go. If he guesses wrong, he's going to lose 54% here.
Good block.
He guesses right. Good job.
And uh-oh. There's the DP by Sonic Fox. This will still do at least 45.
47. And here's the second touch.
And
he's going to take the device.
Yep.
He's,
gonna he's
kill
going
him.
All
there it is.
That life.
Two touches.
So just when you thought Batgirl was a Vortex character, she also does major damage.
Yep. She can do both.
Uh-oh. Oh,
empty
no
jump throw. I like it. Because he has clash.
King mixing it up.
And he can block well. So
bomb.
That.
Wake nice up wake up. Oh, got him on the rollback with Ebola. What's the, oh, and the mix up is overhead. King clashing smartly. This is protection. One of Batgirl's little horns is pointed now. Showing a little bit of that battle damage.
Yeah. Bruce Peter right. up.
Oh, King trips guards.
She has clash, and she used it. No meter. Neither of them had meter. So the clash is tied by default.
And there we go. Nice release of the bat and back three.
King takes it. So we are tied 1-1.
No blowout this time, and we're going to see a change of scenery yet again. Going to the temple on Themyscira. And this could be a nightmare for both characters, seeing as those lion heads are one of the most annoying interactables in the game.
The strings will be pulled, and the fire will be blown.
Let's see who takes first blood. Oh, and Sonic Fox gets the overhead.
Gets him with the low.
And now we're in the corner.
50%. Oh, 42. Okay.
Push block by Sonic Fox. Got him with the low.
He's dead.
Oh,
my God.
He got crossed up into the corner.
I don't know why he didn't go for the damage there. This is going to come back.
I think he was. He just got crossed up into the corner and got a reverse input.
He was too deep.
Yeah.
See, what happens?
Same thing happens to Superman as well sometimes.
Yeah, I know. You get the air grab instead of breath. That's the worst.
And then you meter burn it.
I know. Man, that sucks.
Oh, wow. And King. All right, King opens him up. Will King go for fire? No. We're sitting near the interactable bounce. Uses it. All right, both sitting near their fire. Oh, King looked for the teleport there. King Sonic using Batman's down one. Sonic Fox not pulling the chain at all. And there it is. Oh, and
commentator
King just kind of walks out of the way. And there
it
is there.
The chain will be pulled.
Cartwheel is a multi-hitting move. Sonic Fox choosing not to convert after the cartwheel.
Didn't want him to clash, but he did anyway. Because, as we just said, the cartwheel is a multi-hitting move. Nice jump two. This gonna kill. Oh.
Oh, he went for a setup there. DP one more, and there's a teleport. So that was a quick third game by Sonic Fox.
So 2-1 Sonic Fox.
King changing up the costume and going home.
I'm surprised he didn't pick Martian. He went ahead with Russian Batman.
All right, Sonic Fox gets the first opening and the second opening. And
drops
he drops Calm in the corner, but then he converts it again. Quite close to death here.
53%.
53 and chip at the end as well. That is a perfect.
Yep.
Two touches.
Picks up the bombs. Forever King trying to bait out a teleport to no avail. Trades with the overhead. And King punishes. Set up.
Reset.
Oh, finally gets a hit off that reset.
Ooh.
Oh, wow. Wake up.
Wake up, Batty Bay 3. Dive bomb.
Yeah.
Wake up, Batty Bay 3. Dive kick. All right, so King opts to clash.
Oh, and he takes a lot of damage. Sonic Fox moving into the corner. Oh, but does a dragon punch.
Wake up cartwheel, because he's Sonic Fox. Again.
And there it is, the overhead. So after 3-1. Going 1-1 in the set, Sonic Fox just kind of steamrolled after that.
Yep.
Not allowing King to breathe at all. And Sonic Fox advances to the grand finals. Guaranteed top 2 for Young Dominic.
So King is going to Losers Finals.
All right, so we're heading to the Losers Semifinal.
And he will face the winner of Deg versus Chris G. Now, I think Deg will go Zatanna here because Chris G has no idea how to fight that character.
I believe so too. And if Chris G does seem to get a hold on what Deg is doing, he also does have Aquaman in his pocket, which is an atrocious matchup
like
for Green
8-2.
Arrow. Green Arrow cannot 8-2. Do anything.
I'm serious.
But Chris G does tend to stick it out with Green Arrow, my fault, and he's done incredibly well at this tournament so far. Making it into the top 4 of almost 100 competitors.
The only character Deg has that Chris G is somewhat familiar with is Harley. From playing Ramon a year ago.
And I think Chris G just told him that I have no idea how to fight Zatanna.
I think he did just say that. He said, I have no idea.
He's like,
That's funny.
So we'll see if Chris G's fighting game fundamentals can hold him over with no matchup knowledge. Probably could not even tell you one thing that Zatanna does, but we'll see how he combats this right now.
Good luck to Chris.
All right, we go straight to Themyscira again.
Ready, King.
All right, so we got a button check here. Looks like we're going to get right into it. Restart the match. All right, let's go.
Chris G decides to just jump back at the beginning.
A match you've never seen before on
and
a stream.
I wonder how Chris is going to deal with this zoning.
I don't even know what it is, but he's learning on the fly.
I bet he doesn't know that that has armor.
Yeah.
Chris G going to have to fly by the seat of his pants here, and there's fire also.
Yep.
And this is probably Zatanna's best stage. Saltface talked about having to play Deg on the stage at final round, where you can literally just teleport between the lion heads.
Yeah.
And there's nothing Green Arrow can do to get rid of them, like a power character.
Right.
So he just has to deal with it.
Chris G has no idea what to do right now.
Got him with an arrow. Moving him into the corner.
He's going to have to autopilot.
I think he was actually trying to bait a teleport there.
Uh-oh. Gets it with the combo in the corner.
Nice block by Deg,
jump
and
one.
An air to air.
All right, time to guess. Nope, he's going to do the combo. There's
nope.
The reset.
Oh.
Ooh, he guessed correctly.
Chris Snoke for probably being the person with the best defense probably in the entire fighting game community.
Yep.
Showing it off right here.
Wow.
Deg just going to the zoning.
This ring zoning is too powerful. All right.
So Chris Xi does get the opening.
He has super, and he has clash.
Oh, but he's air-to-air and is going to be forced to clash.
Yeah.
Might bet all four bars if we know Chris Xi, and he does.
He did. He wants to stay in this. He thinks he has a chance here.
Oh, and Deg backdashes and gets in with the, Chris doesn't know that Kix has a low in it.
He's going to reset. Yep.
All right, so...
Because his
Chris
inputs
probably,
were reversed and he was screwed
Chris
anyway.
Probably knew that game one was going to be all learning. So let's see what he does in game two after the adaption.
Yep, that was data, but we'll see what he does with it.
Got to watch out for the fire. Ooh. Nice trade, but not able to get the combo.
Raw back three to beta dash. Meter right. Burn rings have block pressure. Plus frames. Round three, she's in the corner.
Oh, got him with the overhead. Didn't combo though. Her hitbox might be too small.
All right, Chris is looking better than last game, but he
drops
the combo there.
Nice savage blast. Baits the teleport wake up with a jump back. Chris just going in with some pressure right now.
She tries to meter burn back three.
Throws him back into the corner. Smart stuff.
I wonder what Deg is fishing for there with that meter burn.
Oh, but Chris, she just got a little antsy. Deg decided to teleport out yet again. Oh, and he doesn't know that it reverses his inputs. And Chris G just getting an education on Zatanna right now.
Very nice reset by Deg.
Uses the cards. Cards again.
Cards again.
Oh, it's like a Kenshi shoulder in the corner.
52 pickup. Shades of Gambit.
All right, she got him that time, though. Deg possibly getting a little too cute.
Yep. Tries a raw trance there.
Oh, freezes nice trade.
Chris G has super, so you got to keep an eye on that. He's going to do it?
Yep.
No, he's
no,
going to
go
three.
For the transition for free damage, and then the super probably will be the next move.
He's got to do it. If he gets a hit, she's probably going to clash.
Chris Xi getting that arrow loaded. He's going to look to trade sometime.
She's blowing all her meter on the rings, though. She's opting to zone him out. Does
and there's the trade.
Now.
Nope.
Oh,
it does decides okay. Not to go for the super.
Interesting choice there. May come back to haunt him. Let's find
oh,
out.
Oh, but got
do it
in here. Whiff
he
and
do it
super.
Now.
Will Deck go for the backdash? He does not get it.
This is going to be 44%. Unclashable.
Gonna
it's
be
not
quite close
be
to
enough.
Death. Oh,
she's got
wow.
A pixel. 1% arrow. Got her.
And just keeps throwing the arrows until it's death.
Nice,
all right, so.
Very nice adaptation by Chris G. The score is 1-1. He's still in this with no matchup experience whatsoever. Throwing right. The rings.
Oh, and got the bait on the fire.
All right, Chris G goes in for the throw. Wake up cards. He blocks low
oh,
this time.
Nice punish.
He may have figured it out when he got hit by it last time.
Got him with the overhead. Big corner combo incoming. Oh, but Chris drops it.
Meter burn back three.
Chris has had multiple occasions today where that last string on 1-1-1 just seems to whiff. And it is crucial because Green Arrow doesn't get the arrow loaded. But now he's, oh, and drops it again. But nice
wow.
Jump three cross up. All right, well, Chris used the fire.
Chris G has made some severe changes in his favor right now.
Oh, Ice Arrow just misses. Nice jump three by Deg, though. All right, I believe we're going to see some kind of setup here.
Uh-oh.
There it is.
Went for the reset there.
Oh, but just kept it simple.
This is amazing.
Oh, my God. Chris interrupted the down one with his own, but got
his inputs
reversed. Overhead rings. All right, Deg going back to zoning, and a nice catch after the – and he doesn't know it reverses his inputs. I wish I could see Chris's face after that.
Uh-oh,
super. Reset.
All right, it's going to do 44% unclashable.
All Chris going to fire arrows.
He needs to zone her out with these fire arrows.
He's gotta be wary of the teleport though.
And the trance.
Deg looking to trade, goes into hat stance.
He needs two fire arrows to connect.
Chris is like, this is like Morgan, man. She just throws all this stuff. Alright, Chris is looking for one fire arrow. But he loads up an ice arrow.
Deg doing an excellent
going
job.
Back to fire.
Ooh, nice. Catches the
Chris
jump.
Chris has to be careful here.
Oh, my goodness. He, not like this.
Oh, right. But throws another one, and Chris goes up 2-1.
He got her. Deg threw everything he had at him.
All right, and Deg's giving this a think.
He's probably going to Aquaman. Why not? Just do it. Wait, what?
He's kind of hovering. And there it is.
Yep. Scumbag Deg. They're telling him not to do it. Of course he's going to do it. This is tournament. Money's on the line. Got to do what you got to do.
Top three placement is on the line. All right, so we're sitting on the stage select screen. Not sure.
He sold his soul to Poseidon. Ferris Aircraft. Now, I would say gadget characters have the advantage on this stage.
Yeah,
they
would
just camp the missile. They have all kinds of interactables on the screen. But
Chris doesn't like to sit in the corner, though.
Nope. Aquaman shuts down a lot of the stuff Arrow does.
Oh, nice from the deep.
He's just going to do from the deep.
Oh, but got him there. Traits up. All right, and the Florida crowd is going to get hype every Trident Rush.
Wow. Rare footage of Aquaman hype. The crowd is screaming with him. And that's not going to kill, but he threw the Trident at him. From the deep whiffs. Down one, overhead ice arrow. Deg traits up to avoid the combo. Aquaman's trait can...
And there's a down two.
Aquaman's trait is basically a combo breaker. That's all it is.
Especially against Green Arrow, where his only real launcher is Ice Arrow.
It's terrible.
And there's the trait
and
again.
And he does it again. There's nothing down Green two. Arrow can do about this.
And I believe Chris will counterpick with some type of character. Not sure who.
Jump three reset. And Deg is camping the missiles. And he hits Green Arrow because his jump arc is bad. Oh, man. Down two. Doesn't get the combo because... Well, right. He didn't want him to clash, but...
I'm not sure what Chris is going to do here. His
that match looks so hopeless.
Yeah. His old counterpick for Aquaman used to be Black Adam.
But he doesn't feel confident in his Black Adam anymore. Nope. And he personally does not feel confident in his Black Adam anymore. He hasn't used him in a while. He's thinking about it.
I could see look at the look on his face. Yeah, he's really perplexed at this moment. Just not sure what to do.
Batgirl would not be a wise choice.
Hovering over Green Arrow.
That's also Aquaman favor. But he's going to do it anyway.
Thinking about I think that's just better overall.
It's better than Green Arrow.
Right.
You know what? All of his characters have losing matchups, so out of his characters, Batgirl is the best choice.
Is the best choice.
I take
agree.
It back. So he's got to deal with it. Unless he just wants to pull out a random alt on the fly, which would be ill-advised. Chris G's really thinking about this. He's defending his title, the defending champion in loser's bracket, having a character dilemma right now. Character crisis.
And this is huge because it is for top three.
Yes,
still
sir.
Hovering over Batgirl, shaking his head a little bit that he has to make this decision.
This is to get into loser's finals and meet Forever King.
And...
He went. Oh no!
Chris is gonna go arrow.
He's sticking with his guns.
And I respect that.
I respect it too. If he's gonna go out, he's
gonna
go out.
But I'm not sure it's the right decision.
He's riding his horse all the way to the end.
But if Chris G can pull this out, oh my gosh! And we're going right back to the temple. But at least it's not Satana this time. It is Aquaman. And here we go.
We are
game five.
2-2. This for losers finals. Top three. Chris G's the defending champion. Deg is the challenger. who was here last year.
All right, Deg opens with the big interactable. Right, Chris is gonna. I think Chris will go for a lot more throws this round. That seems to be one of the only ways he's gonna get damage.
Because the ice arrow is a no-no.
Nice block on the meter burn back three, and here's all that chip. Oh, but Trait comes back.
Oh, he throws him.
Trait came back right as Chris G was able to start a combo.
Yep.
And
can't back three after
is
that
from
ice
the deep.
Arrow. Because Aquaman's combo breaker is not gonna allow him to do
and
it.
Nice trip guard with down one. Deg looking strong. Chris has to find answers.
Trident Rush does 15% chip.
All right, and Chris is just deciding to go for mix-ups, and he got him that time. No trait now. Chris opens him up. Oh, wake up, Trident Rush.
And about 27%
and
on hit.
Pack one Trident Rush.
Sometimes 28.
And there's a trip guard. Chris is forced to clash. Most likely going to bet all of his meter here. Take as much life back as he can.
He is fighting for his life right now in this terrible matchup. 15% chip.
Got him with a trip guard again.
That's
this is going to be 40%.
It's going to hurt. Reset.
Set up. Oh, got him with down one scoop.
The SoCal special.
All right, and here we go. Chris now has him in the corner. Got to watch out. Chris has got to be careful.
Down
and
two.
There's a down two.
That's
and
it.
And Chris just decides to give it up.
Chris G forfeits the title to Deg. It was a hopeless situation anyway.
Still a great showing by Chris G. Top four at CEO.
We will be crowning a new champion today, ladies and gentlemen, between Forever King, Deg 222, and Sonic Fox. These are our contenders. So Forever King stepping up right now. Deg sitting right back in the hot seat. So the question is, who will Deg use against Forever King? He has played him online a lot with Zatanna, and King knows the matchup well. So I think he's going to go to Aquaman here, and King might pick Martian.
It's very possible. I could see them both leading with their mains, and then it becoming just that back-and-forth counterpick fest. So it's crucial, if they do pick their mains, who wins the first game.
If that does happen, yes. All right, they're going to do a button check right here. So they'll just go into it with their main characters. All right, so Forever King, he's got several top eights under his belt. He won Yumacon, and he won KIT. Deg, his only majors were CEO last year and final round this year. And he got top eight last year at CEO, and he got ninth at final round, losing to Rio to qualify for top eight. Rio pulled a real master comeback there with his Martian against Deg Zatanna. Rio also did not know the Zatanna matchup. He was talking to Zyfox about it for 20 minutes before he played. It was really impressive. Oh, man. He went straight to Aquaman, as I expected from Deg, but I thought King would go to Martian.
Deg may have blind picked him. I'm not sure. I didn't see on the character select screen.
That's true. We were just looking at their faces.
And here's Trident Rush. Nice catch of the backdash.
Uh-oh, doesn't get the combo there. Does Trident Rush. 15% chip.
Who needs combos, man, when you have... Oh, wow.
Oh, releases a bat in the middle of Trident Rush.
Saw the whiff, and that is an insane reaction by Forever King.
Very nice.
All right, good blocks by Deg.
Uh-oh, the Forever King block string.
Oh, got him low.
Got him.
Cross up.
Cross
nice
up.
Block.
Yep. 15% chip.
Deg trading up. Oh, got him with his own
wow.
Cross up. Wanted to scoop him back into the corner, but he dies before he can.
Yep. All right, we're all tied up right now. Aquaman has near full meter. Forever King has one bar, releases the bats.
And I'm sure King is used to this at this point, people picking Aquaman against him just to try to get around his Batman.
Ooh, nice sparkles.
but it is not working incredibly well for Deg right now.
Nope.
What a nice down two off the meter burn Batarang. And King clashes, but with a very disadvantageous meter situation.
Yep, he's going to take the damage. Now he's got one bar for Trident Rush, too.
That was a nice punish.
So he can do 15% chip or 28 on hit. Or he's just going to get his health back with this clash. Let's see how many bars he bets here. It's going to be two or one. He did both.
Decides to bet two.
Because Batman packs a punch from anywhere on the screen when he opens you up. Here we go.
No trade able here.
27%.
Bombs.
Oh, we got him with one. Traded with the from the deep. Releases the bat.
King was so close to having a trip guard. Nice jump over by Deg.
He is dead.
And that is a nice convert. Also, Deg taking game number one.
King's got to pick Martian.
King,
no other
option. King may run to Wonder Woman, actually.
He should pick Martian.
Or go right back to Batman. Just going to change the
stage.
Why?
No.
Here
we
go. Oh, Flash. I forgot he does have Flash.
He needs to pick Martian.
Oh,
yes!
Here we go.
There you go.
All right. And
there
he does
you go,
choose
King.
Martian. DMS with the good call here.
Thank you. That's his best option in this matchup.
King saying, I'll do what Perfect Legend could not do.
Ooh.
Trying to take out Deg's Aquaman.
That is something King would say.
Taking a couple from the deeps early. And this is going to be a chip war from full screen, but King is losing, getting opened up.
Tries to try to rush the teleport. Oh, gets him with the last part of that string there.
All right, here comes the setup. Tree.
Yep. Gets the tree
reset.
Shout out
to Slayer.
Shades of Theo versus Jupiter from MLG.
King trying to keep the mix-ups going. Beats out the meter burn back three.
With multiple hits.
Deg with a smart trade. And now King is just one teleport away. Probably do instant teleport here. No. And
jump
gets
two.
Air-to-aired. The Magic Pixel doing a lot of work.
All right, he's going to throw the lion's head. Nope. Teleport.
Oh, got him with a teleport there.
It's going to chip him regardless.
I'm surprised King didn't go for the lion head here. Deg with a smart meter burn back three, and King is forced to clash. All right, so we're about even health here.
Martian's got a meter.
Oh, wow, and Aquaman did the dance of confusion where he didn't know which side Martian was on. Nice block that time, though.
Back to you.
All right, try to rush. Oh, and just walks up and scoops him.
SoCal special. All right, he gets 15% health back. Pillar. Reversal Trident Rush. Blocks it. Ooh, nice
oh,
nice backdash.
Oh, wow. That was a crazy backdash, but got caught the second time.
Yep.
And King is going to keep losing that chip war if he keeps trying.
You can't just do raw teleports. Deg is scouting it. Martian has full meter here. Neither
right,
of them have
the crowd saying, just walk back.
Yep. That's what Aquaman should be doing here.
Oh, wow, nice jump. And Deg confirms again.
That's 2-0 Deg. He started off with Aquaman. It was a great choice.
All right.
What's he doing here?
We're on the...
Wonder Woman. There we go. All right, so King's going through all his alts here.
Going back to the Batcave.
Yep.
Got Jabali entering the ring.
Down two, trades. Down one, Trident Rush. He doesn't have the meter.
Oh, and a nice bait out on the meter burn back three. Deg getting a combo. Just getting the meter also to continue it.
Another Trident Rush. She does back two and a lasso. Dash forward. What's the setup? Crossover jump
down
two.
Down three.
Down one, Trident Rush again. That's 28%.
Oh, my goodness. Trident Rush.
So much Trident Rush.
And even when there's not an Aquaman main, even in the tournament, we have him in top three.
That says a lot.
Don't need his help here.
All right. Down two.
Scouting out the air dash.
Converts to the combo.
Oh, punishes the demigoddess. It's going to be big damage, and Deg is taking a huge lead here.
She's got super.
Oh, my God. Baits the dash.
Didn't have the meter to meter burn that Trident.
Nice
burn.
Neutral jump. Oh, but goes to scoop instead of Trident, and that could have been
two.
In. Oh,
and
King,
it's over. Yep.
King, I believe, hopeless. Wanted demigoddess there, but got an Amazonian uppercut, and that will be 3-0 for Deg. King looks a little off.
So Deg versus Sonic Fox, the run back. You think he's going to go straight to Aquaman?
I'm not sure. I believe he will because he's got to get that bracket reset.
Yep.
After the reset, he might be able to play around a little bit, but
I'd stick with what's working.
Yeah.
And right now what's working is Aquaman.
But Sonic Fox has been known to love that matchup, apparently, with Batgirl.
Yep. He told Deg to his face, don't do it.
Yeah.
Yesterday. So if you're planning on picking Aquaman on me, don't do it. He has a good record
but
against Aquaman.
At this point, Deg may not have any other options.
He beat Theo 3-2 in the free tournament at MLG with a real master comeback for the headset. Good thing no one saw that. He's thinking about it right now. You can see it in his face.
And during the button check, he has selected Aquaman.
Now, Sonic Fox has a major victory under his belt with several very good placements and within the top four. He won final round. He placed second at Winter Brawl. I see he didn't go to UFGC.
Just missed out on top eight at MLG.
Yes. And he got second at Civil War.
And I believe second at ECT
as well. Yeah.
Oh, down two trades. All right, so grand finals beginning, and Deg going with Aquaman, and Trident rushes out early.
Deg made a good choice here by picking Aquaman. Because Sonic Fox has a pocket Zatanna himself, so he might be familiar with the mix-ups. Trait negates her vortex.
Nice, meter burn. Oh, somehow the teleport.
I guess
caught.
He pressed a button there.
Yeah. It didn't look like Deg was in any kind of recovery, but oh, wow. Crosses I'm not sure if that was a cross up. There are those weird things in this game where a jump in will look like it hits in front, but then they end up behind you. Just some crazy stuff going on.
Yes, sir.
Deg with a nice convert off the uppercut.
Deg's looking very good here.
Sonic Fox buffering teleport, it looks like. Nice down one punish on the cartwheel.
Now you got to take a look at Aquaman's meter. When he does the meter burn Trident rush on chip,
watch
he builds
it go.
Back
ding 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 ding.
75% of it.
All right, but Deg has to be careful here. He is in the corner and has meter disadvantage. But Sonic Fox is going for the punishable version of that cartwheel. Well, all of them are punishable if you guess right.
All right, Sonic Fox wets it all. Gets all of his health back.
Nice down two. No meter. There's the electric wires.
Deg still converts off of them.
I hate those wires. All right, and Deg is so close from taking game one, but gets punished for a Trident.
Wake up, help.
Oh, but Sonic Fox drops a combo, and then Deg doing another punish, but why is he
it's
not
hurt?
Oh, and he clashes at the end of the combo.
He's going to get some health back, though, and he's out of the corner. Is he going to bet both?
Sonic Fox, I believe, is one Trident rush away, and
yep.
Oh, push block, smart
push block
move
down
by
one.
Sonic Fox,
yep.
And there's a teleport.
What?
But
what?
Deg does a punishable instead of just
that?
Going in. Okay. Right.
He
and it doesn't come back to bite him, but all he had to do was Trident rush.
All he had to do was Trident rush, and he did from the deep for some reason. I don't know why. All right, she starts with a down two.
And I believe
too early.
Sonic Fox might have actually wanted the flying uppercut instead of his regular one.
That makes sense. He was trying to do flying bat there.
Nice punish of the misspaced Trident Rush. Oh, caught him with a trip guard back too. Going to the corner, big damage. Good blocks by Deg. Oh my gosh, and that's the first time Sonic Fox has done the low, and he still blocked it.
All right, he's gonna punish that teleport.
No meter combo finishes the round, and Deg looking strong. There's the flying bat. Sick. Got him with the overhead though.
Yep.
Stuffed his wake up too.
She can do that. He's gonna do cartwheel. Yep.
Oh, just kind of looked like he baited something out there. Oh, nice trade by Deg though.
Doesn't matter.
Wake up,
Trident Rush.
Ooh, and just barely misses out on the down two. And Sonic Fox tried to beat him there.
He needs
Deg was on point though.
All right, Deg wants no part of this. Looks like Sonic Fox is going to bet some meters here.
Looks like
Deg
will most likely tie.
Oh, Sonic Fox bet more.
That was a nice convert off the bullet. Got what he could.
Oh, down two. Shouldn't have jumped.
Sonic Fox does not have meter.
Nope.
Oh, and there it is.
All right. Are they going to trade here? This is crucial. All right. Clash is tied. Neither has meter. Oh, my goodness.
One more Trident Rush, and there it is.
That's 2-0. Deg on his way to resetting the bracket here. He's got one more.
Going back to the character select screen.
Sonic Fox sticking with Batgirl. Deg sticking with Aquaman. Well, duh. But we're going to Wayne Manor Knight. Sonic Fox loves this stage. Absolutely loves it. Every time he's in training mode, he goes straight to Wayne Manor. So he's going to feel like he's at home.
All right, Sonic Fox. Oh, man, got him with the cartwheel to open him up. Tried to rush back. Got the piano out of the way.
Another Trident Rush by Deg, 28%.
Oh, and Deg got an input error there and wasted his trait. Sonic Fox gets free mix-ups, wake up scoop.
I approve.
Down one Trident Rush.
15%.
Sonic Fox somehow got hit at the end there.
You press the button.
Oh, stuffs the cartwheel on wake up.
So much Trident Rush.
Down nice two. Down two. Oh, but drops the combo.
Cannot jump on Aquaman for free. Full combo punish.
And this is going to be big damage for one bar, probably 50%.
45.
And Trident Rush. Punishes the cartwheel. Sonic Fox just reaching for things he doesn't have to go for, but it looks like we might see a bracket reset here. But Sonic Fox is actually still in the game.
He's still in it. Two touches.
Oh, and Deg tried to trade. I'm not sure why. That doesn't work against teleport.
All right, puts him in the corner.
Oh, wake up
trying to
rush
again.
Sonic Fox smartly jumps back. Oh, and I believe that was a punish. Long range options for Batgirl with that 11 frame cartwheel.
Ooh, nice bat evade.
And I'm going to say, Sonic Fox should not dash here because Deg is looking for it with that down one. All right, Deg is one guess away, but so is Sonic Fox.
He
and
trades
the trade.
And still gets a combo.
Didn't meter burn.
Drops it.
But got him with a trip guard, and that is a bracket reset. 3-0.
Yes, so much Trident Rush.
And Sonic Fox needs an answer here.
Guys, go ahead to make this interesting. Start a little drinking game in the chat. Count the Trident Rushes. Take a
each
swing.
Little poke. Each poke?
Yeah. Each poke, yeah. Someone's going to die. Not each poke. Each Trident Rush. Just count them. Take a swig. Crowd getting hype in the back for the reset.
The local Florida crowd cheering on Deg.
Yep. They're all in that huddle over there.
Trying to defend the house here at CEO for Injustice.
All right, let's see if Sonic Fox adapts to Deg's Aquaman. Another, there's one.
They're gonna die your way too. There's two.
Yeah, these
nice
guys are
punish
die.
Though.
Yeah, take a drink of water every time he does his Rider Rush.
CEO is not responsible for any alcohol poisoning because of DMS's Rider Rush game.
That disclaimer.
Oh, baits the Trident
Wakes
Rush
up
on
with Trident Rush again. Sonic Fox blows it up.
And it looks like Sonic Fox has found some answers. Got him in the corner too. Dex gotta be careful.
So far we're up
good
to
blocks though.
Up four.
Oh no, and he got an input error. Sonic Fox smartly punishes with an instant launcher.
Oh, and just gonna cross up. Nope, he went for the low. Missile.
Jump three in the missile. I believe that is guaranteed. Her jump three is quite plus on block.
Sonic Fox made some drastic changes to his game here. Oh, did the random teleport and got punished for it.
But luckily it was just only for 19% that. Life.
Now he's gotta stop doing that. Just be smart right now.
Going into Thunder Knuckles.
Projectile. Good job.
All right, so Sonic Fox takes the first game directly after the bracket reset.
Shutting down Deg's Wake Up Trident Rush. He's gotta keep that up. Sonic Fox. 1-0 Sonic Fox in the reset. They are both in loser's bracket right now. The screen freeze? Well,
I don't know.
The game froze.
Alrighty then.
All right, so it looks like we might have to.
Apparently, the game froze.
Possibly, we'll have a system swap or
reset.
Yeah.
Just turn it off and turn it back on. No big deal. Sonic Fox got Fire Liger coaching him. It's all good.
Apparently the game froze, so.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
So sit tight, stream. We will take care of these technical difficulties.
Run some Pizza Hut ads.
Oh, no. No, the nightmares, man. Blake Shelton is haunting my dreams after the last weekend.
I'm glad I didn't see any of that. Well, I'll just read these. Take 20% off our new stuff until this stream ends. We guarantee our clothes won't get blown up in the wash. Shoutouts to all the stream warriors from Broken Tear. Shoutouts to Koogie. All right, we've got official Capcom Pro Tour CEO 2014 event t-shirt. Available now at teespring.com/CEO. Available in white and in black. CapcomProTour.com, CEOGaming.org. Get the official CEO 2014 event t-shirt available now at teespring.com/CEO2014. It's Jabali approved. $10 coupon code for orders, $50 plus CEO5. $15 coupon code for orders, $100 plus CEO2014 at 8arc.com. There's our social media links right there.
All right, and it looks like we've got the system running back up.
That was quick.
All right, and they're going to...
How many Trident Rushes do we have? I counted four.
All right, and it looks like they're going to check for the hot fix really quick. Just to make sure we don't have any problems with that.
All right, we're up to four Trident Rushes, so no one has died yet.
Uh-oh.
Batgirl, Aquaman.
Alleyway is one of the random stages. Oh, and it gets it.
For those just joining us, the bracket was reset by Deg. He started off with Aquaman, didn't bother with Zatanna, and he's up. Sonic Fox is up 1-0 in the reset bracket. Deg won the first one 3-0.
All right, and it looks like we're going to go to the alleyway, see if check buttons real quick.
Just to make sure they're right, because the system was reset, and that does happen. Sonic Fox with the furry coaching. That's his inspiration right there.
All right.
I think we're good to go. Restart the match.
One of the major things this set is going to be how Deg deals with the dumpster.
Yep. This stage is in Batgirl's favor. So
and
that dumpster's gone.
Dumpster comes early. Oh. Not able to punish that this time.
There's five.
Sonic Fox right next to the dumpster. Deg smartly punishes the dash in.
Six.
Nice teleport. Deg needs to stop wasting his trade on that, but I guess it is just a kind of knee-jerk reaction to doing something punishable.
Ooh! Nice dumpster reset by Sonic Fox. Takes the first health bar.
And Deg is in trouble here. If he goes down 2-0, he'll have to switch the stage.
You face the might of Atlantis.
Let's finish this.
All right, Deg opts to early clash because Batgirl packs a punch in the corner. Two hits, she'll kill you. He's got a meter for the Trident Rush. That brings us to 7.
Oh, and Sonic Fox tried to punish just a little out of range there. Nice interrupt. And he's just going to go straight damage here, not allowing Aquaman to use his trait. Getting near the dumpster. Uses it, but gets punished.
Oh, no, he dropped the combo.
Deg drops the combo.
And he's dead.
And that is dead. Going to player select. Down 2-0.
He's down 2-0. What's he going to do here?
Just switching the stage.
Sticking with Aquaman, changing the stage. Sonic Fox is one game away from winning this tournament, being your new CEO 2014 champion. He won final round back in March, and this will be his second major victory. And right before Evo, too. So he's going in with a lot of momentum. If he were to win right now, Deg can bring it back. We've seen a lot of 0-2 comebacks.
Oh, and that jump 2 just sticks out of hitbox. Got him with the overhead.
Jump 2, use the interactable, into the corner with him.
Got him with the overhead, and Sonic Fox is just going in right now. Bombs. Boom. Oh my goodness. And if there was a stage that you don't want to get after Allie, it might be this one.
Yep.
That car does not ever go away.
Catches him with the meter burn.
And
teleport.
This could be just curtains. Sonic Fox looking to put on a show right now.
Yep.
Deg's got a lot of work to do to bring it back.
He does. So that's 8, and that was 9. That's 10. Deg is not going out without spamming the Trident Rush. That's 11. Jesus. He's going to do it again. Oh, so many cartwheels.
Sonic Fox just over and over.
That's 12.
Good punish 13. This time. All right.
Deg wins this whole game with Trident Rush. God help me.
Sonic Fox is playing a little risky. Oh.
Is he going to clash?
Guns?
Nope. He chooses not to clash. Back one.
Sonic Fox is going to go for super. He's definitely going to go for super. He wanted it right there.
14.
I told you.
Dash up super.
Make
got
him watch.
Too.
Make him watch. No. Unpause the game.
Nope. And Deg unplugs his controller.
Right now.